Sportswoman is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Welcome back. This is still Sportswoman. Let's rush a bit. We have a few minutes left. Let's talk about Moses Mwabuko stepping aside as FUFA president. Do you think there is any chance for him to bounce back after investigations?
I don't know. Maybe. If he's confident enough to step down. My only issue is...
Someone was saying it's hard for a Ugandan.
Actually, even me, if, no, not even a chichamu. For me, I just feel there's the politics being played with the FIFA itself. Sikulimba. Because if you go to the FIFA websites,
there is nothing.
Honestly, there is nothing.
The investigation is non-existent.
I mean, honestly. Because me, I told people, we should not even jubilate at all. Because Magogo is going to come back. First of all, it has not even been proved anywhere that he was even found guilty. Actually, he was even man enough to announce in the AGM in Adjumani, West Nile, that he's stepping down. Some people would not even announce that.
He said he stepped down for investigation.
For 2 weeks.
For investigation.
I mean, for 2 months.
I think coming from the continents that we come from where people like are fixated on power, I think the FUFA president is trying to prove a point. And say I'm not that power hungry.
Which I think was right of him.
And I'm innocent, so I can easily give people time to investigate. Then I'll come back. But you know, for me, I'm just irked by the whole idea that there's even an investigation in the first place. Mm. That is what is irking me. Like, it's not a case of if he's innocent, well and good. But you know, these things of there ain't no smoke without fire.
Anyway,
prove his innocence.
Anyway, some people think maybe it is a fight that Honorable Alan Sawanyan is trying to put up, being the shadow minister for sports. And of course, you know, his fights, he has been fighting here and left and right with Magogo. And some people think probably Alan Sawanyan wants to climb that ladder of becoming the next FUFA president. But we know, for you to become a FUFA president, the law is very clear. We know it very well. And so I would not want so much to go into, actually, even as some journalists, I was there at Lugogo during the Proline Express game that Proline Express lost. Even as some journalists, a friend of mine, that why didn't even come when I had a press conference? I wanted to show the whole world how this man is. And then I'm like, okay, is this man now becoming too personal or what? So that is what the whole point is.
Have been personal. Even Misaka has been personal. Anyway, let's forget about that. Let's talk about McKinstry being appointed as the new head coach.
Babyface.
Where does it live? Yes, babyface. People were saying that.
I was happy to shake hands with him yesterday. By the way, I shook hands with him yesterday. At Nambole. I welcomed him to Nambole. I hosted him. Really? I went and gave him the team lineup. I said, I'm the PRO of Sports Club Villa. You're most welcome. You know that African smile. And he was like, oh, yeah? And he was all smiling.
I mean,
there are so many thirsty women in Uganda.
You understand?
But they went on Facebook and said, some guy, some journalist, Gund, Omwana wa Mami, Henry Yagambi, Adong, please, when you go on the show with your fellow ladies also, tell those slay queens to leave our baby face alone.
They should leave him.
He should concentrate.
Anyway, for me, I'm curious. He's here, 100, but what did he do for Rwanda?
And we are yet waiting. But he has a lot to offer. His CV is big. Yeah? He's the first, actually, who made Sierra Leone climb to the biggest ladder of around being the 50th in the whole world in FIFA ranking. So you can't take him for a ride. He actually even took Rwanda to Chan finals. Yes, his target is he's taking Uganda to World Cup. And that is in 2022. Yes, that's what he said. And that is what we want.
Exactly.
We don't care whether we go past group stages, but for us, it is going. That is
going
to
go. It's
what we want. It's, but kube golo munana, nenga chiri titutu seyo is
anyway,
what we want.
Okay. Yeah. From what I've seen of the manager, I'm actually excited that Uganda has gone young, because I think where football is going, modern football, it's going young, and I think he's someone who can offer us something different from what we are used to.
Okay, we've seen the McKinstry stuff and everything of the like. Where does it put our local coaches?
Yes, of course the local coaches won. For me, if you'd ask me honestly on a national television like this, I'll be honest to say, for me, I am still very grateful for the Federation to hire foreign coaches. Why? Given the history of local coaches, those back then in the days when we were still kids, all of us here, you'd hear stories of a local coach being the head coach. You hear a liner full of Uvira. Yes, it's okay. Aunt Katina, for us, our problem is you hire a coach of Uvira, 90% of the players will be from Vira. KCCA, the same thing. And you've seen what has happened in the national team. What happened to Abdallah Mubiru when we summoned this squad that went to play against Rwanda? Burundi. There's a lot of stories coming out that why were some players summoned, ABCD. So for me, I think FUFA was very right. For now, we still need to have these foreign coaches until our domestic coaches. Polish.
In 1 minute, let's talk about yesterday's game, Floodlights in Nambole, Vipers, Villa. Do you think Villa is now stable?
Not yet very stable. This one, we have to put it very correct. And of course, notably, we would love to at least identify some few of improvement from Sports Club Villa. If you look at Saidi Kenny, he has improved a lot. I was very impressed.
Because of
Samson Chiria. Now, we said all Villa needs is a competition to have a keeper who is going to give competition to Kenny. But again, notably, I will not forget remarkably to talk about Emmanuel Kaliowa. Kaliowa has really tremendously improved a lot. Last season, he had a very sluggish performance, but this time round, even coming out scoring 2 goals, and still yesterday he happened to score a goal, much as it was an offside, seemingly an offside goal from the referee. I think, seemingly, that is the language they use in football. I think Villa is good to go, because if you remember last season, Vipers was comfortably beat Villa 3-1 at Nambole, but this time round, even the bio was overhyped. The overhyped bio was nowhere. It was 50-50. So me, I see Villa going back.
Okay, so today's game, Vipers Pro Line.
That one is also another draw we are going for.
Faith. Pro Line.
Meanwhile, Vipers. I travel to Jinja. We are going to play Busoga United. For Machirinya, we are going to Jinja.
Faith,
so me, I won't be here.
What are you looking up to over the weekend?
How about KCCA that missed 2 penalties? Honestly,
we'll
you guys.
Talk about KCCA
missing 2 penalties.
Anyway,
this one I cannot forget to talk about it.
We'll never keep quiet. This is Sportswoman. My name is Becky Cynthia, and on behalf of the team, good afternoon.
Sportswoman is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.